Hello, hello, hello. This is Frida. Welcome to my channel. I hope everyone's doing well. It's been a while since I have posted a video on for YouTube. I've been crazy busy trying to finish my custom orders, and I'm working on another one. So as soon as I finish this bridal shrug that I am knitting, I am going to be doing some tutorials because I need to make some tutorials because they've been building up. And so I did finish the body parts. So hopefully I will mail this as soon as I finish. I'm working on the sleeve just to give you a look. And the yarn that I am using, I would not recommend this yarn. This is the first time I have, I paid a fortune for this yarn. So I bought a box. I think I bought it from UK on Etsy. See, the thing is, when you see a yarn, you grab it right away or else you can't find it anymore. It's like some people are selling their stash. They want to get rid of it, or what they're doing is they're, you know, trying to make money. So this yarn, it's called Fonti. I believe it's made in Italy. Just going to check. It's like 25 gram of 80% Angora rabbit yarn. And 20% it says wool. And it's made in France. But I really didn't like the quality of the yarn. What I noticed is I didn't like it while I was knitting it, and it's just the quality of the, it is fluffy halo as you can see, but I won't buy it again. But I did buy white color as well, so with the same yarn, same brand. So I do have this brand in my stash, but if I see it again, I won't buy it. Yeah. So just wanted to share. Okay, today the reason I am here is I'm going to be doing an unboxing. Two boxes arrived. One arrived today and one arrived last week. But I wanted to do the unboxing in front of you guys. And actually, I'm waiting for another box, and it looks like it's showing that it's in Vancouver, but it hasn't moved since the 12th of August. So I said, forget it. When that arrives, I will do the unboxing. Other than that, I'm going to show you two unboxings. One is yarn related and one is handmade. So let's open the yarn related. Okay, again, let me just, it's under my chair here. Just grab it. Okay, here they are. So one is this box that arrived. I bought it from Etsy. And the box that I just showed you, the 80% Angora rabbit, I bought that from Etsy as well, but it was shipped from UK. So when I see Angora rabbit yarn, I grab it right away. I don't wait. If I don't have the money, I use my credit card and I try to pay it off as soon as I make a sale. Well, I try to make the full amount payment. And here is the handmade item that I bought from Turkey, and it arrived from DHL. I did pay custom fee for this. This was from Canada, so no custom fee for that. So for this one, I paid $42.41. Because the seller who mailed it to me, she wrote down the value. So I'm not going to give out the name of these stores. Because I wouldn't recommend. So what she did is she wrote down the value. She put down the postage fee as well. So I paid like $10.40 for the product. And then what she did is she added the shipping fee. She put down 260 euro, I believe. Yeah, I can't even read it. Where did I see that? Here it is. Okay, let me just to be on the Oh, she wrote down. Well, actually, she wrote down Turkish, did I? Did she? Yeah. So what they did is DHL or customs, which when they go and they open this box, that's why I do not recommend ordering anything yarn related, FedEx, DHL. I would not recommend. I would recommend, highly recommend, buying it through regular post and then go through that. Because every time you receive a package from DHL, FedEx, UPS, they charge you custom fee. If you live in Canada, okay. If you don't live in Canada, you don't have to worry about this. But for us, because it said 260 Turkish dinar, let me just convert that to Canadian. TL to... It's a small amount. It's not a big amount. So let me just convert it. So 260 Turkish lira is, when you round it, it's not even $40 Canadian. So it's not a big amount. But when they look at it, oh, they say euro. They just said euro, or I don't know. What I called and talked to the people, and they said that they opened the package and they valued it where it came from, where was it shipped from, and what the product is. So they made their own, because they have to charge me. That's what their deal is. They need to charge me something. So I paid, and I think this is ridiculous, like I paid $42.41. So I will not buy from the seller. It's not her fault. She tried to ship it with the best quality shipping and fastest way. It arrived in 4 days. I believe she shipped it on Thursday and it arrived today. I think so. So that's another thing. And it arrived fast, but like I said, I had to pay custom fee. And for us who live in Canada, that adds up. So I'm not happy with it. So let's go and open this box. So for this, I paid $250, including the shipping. This is from Canada. Okay, so let me open this. I think she duct taped it very securely. So I have to find the opening of the box. So let me find that and I'll be right back, because it's gonna take me a while. It's because it's been taped very nicely. Can you see? Be right back. Okay, so I opened the box. Okay, I believe I bought two combs, but it looks like she taped it. Okay, so here's a bag. It's been nicely packed. So as soon as I see Angora rabbit yarn, I buy it. I'm not gonna wait, because Angora, I get at least two orders a month. And I just don't want, I want the yarn in my inventory. Because as soon as, okay, here it is. So this is 80% Angora rabbit, I believe. Pure lana, Italy. Angora, super. Yeah, it doesn't look much. And here's the other one. So I bought two listings. She had two listings. Oh, look at that. So she did cake it. So I believe this is not pure white. It is like off-white. Like a tint of... It's just a... Can look, can you see? It's not that halo compared to this. Can you see? But what I'll do is, because this yarn is very thin, I will add this to a different brand yarn and then work with that. But it does give you a halo look, see? So you can't knit one strand. You need to make it at least double. See, you need to double strand it. It won't work with one strand. So that's the reason I bought two cone. And one is caked. Yeah. As soon as I see, like I said, as soon as I see Angora rabbit, you know, especially in Canada, it's really hard. But I found this in Canada on Etsy, so I did not have to pay custom fee. And the shipping fee was only like $12. And she shipped it with expedited it. Arrived super fast, so I'm happy with it. It arrived like in a week, 7 to 10 days. So I'm happy with it. It arrived safe and sound. And I didn't have to pay custom fee. The one that I did an unboxing about, the Angora rabbit yarn, I did have to pay a custom fee for that. But yeah, I might even add that to this and work it out. Yeah, so I'm happy with my order. Nice. Okay, let's come to this DHL box. Okay, after buying so many things, paying so much custom fees, paying so much shipping fee, you learn things, right? Even I told the seller, please don't ship it with DHL. She kind of argued with me and she said, no, I'm not shipping with DHL. And she took the picture of the box and it said DHL on it. And I said, it says DHL on the box. But, and after that, I didn't want to argue anymore because, you know, if they don't know. And it was her first time shipping to Canada. So, yeah, live it, learn it. But I've been learning it, living it so many times, all these years, all this time. So, I'm really not happy. You know, even you warn the seller. Okay, so I'm just cutting. When the customs opened it, it says repacked. If you remember, one of my packages arrived open and it was all damaged, stained all over the fabric. I'm still fighting for that. So, yeah, it's been 2 weeks. And so I told DHL, tell your people to pack it. Like, I don't want my packages to arrive open, right? It was wide open, the bag. So this one, they did pack it. It said repackaged. So at least they're listening. So I am assuming this arrived open and then DHL had to pack it again, tape it. Okay, so let me just cut this tape and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm still opening because there's so many tapes on it. And I was just reading this. It's in a red it's a security checked. Like, I don't understand. There's nothing in it, just fabric. What are you checking? It's so stupid. I don't know what's going on. Just fabric, yarn. You know, when you buy yarn, why are you checking? So it said, securities checked. Oh my goodness. The content of the package have been checked for security purposes by the persons named. And there's a signature. Oh my goodness. I just can't believe it. It's just fabric. Like, it's a curtain panel I bought. I could have sat down and made it myself, but it's going to take me forever, you know, to buy the supply, to buy the thread for the sewing machine. And I said, I'll just buy it. It's already made. Yeah. If I go to Fabric Land. That's another thing. So I thought it's already made, right? I will support someone. Okay. Oh my goodness. They tape everything. So I'm trying to pull these cracks. And oh my goodness. Okay. Let's see if I can. Oh, it's taped here too. I'll be back. Take me forever to open this. Okay, I opened it. Yay! Okay, so I'm opening it. You guys are going to see the first time before I do. Okay, here we go. Let's see. Ta-da! Can you see? The fabric. It's just fabric. Nothing to it. Okay, let me just open and pull this out. Oh, I think she put lavender. That's why they're picky. So, yeah. That happened to me. I sent the bridal shrug to Mexico. Mexico, whichever you pronounce it. And I put a chasse, like a lavender. Oh my goodness. Customs went in and out of the box. And, yeah. Because of the... She wrapped it really neatly. Can you see? With a tissue. And then here is a little card she put down with lavender. Can you see? So I'm assuming they thought it's drugs. Yeah. Okay. Let me just open this So I don't ship any lavender chassés. I only ship it through Canada. I don't put, even to the United States of America, I don't put chassés anymore. Those lavender chassés, you know, they smell nice. Okay. Oh. It smells beautiful. Come on, I need to go and buy more stuff from her. It smells so good. Oh, she must have sprayed perfume or some sort of thing. Oh, wow, this is nice. I don't want to open it. I did share one with pictures, and I made a video on TikTok about this curtains that I'm going to hang on my kitchen / dining room. I have two big windows, about 150 centimeter long. So I'm going to hang them on them and just give a little feminine look. Because I don't like the office look with those blinds, you know, that it has. My kitchen and dining room, the sun is inside. So I have those blinds that protect the inside. I don't want that sun, too much sun in the house. So I wanted to decorate it. And so that's the reason I found this. And I'm just going to open these tissue, and I'll be right back to show you the panels. Okay, I'm just comparing. I bought from three places, Handmade, Crochet / Embroidery, and this is the best one that I received, nicely tissued, packed in a bag. So I don't know, I don't want to buy anything for 6 months. This was my last purchase, but just want to show you. Can you see? So this is the corner. Let me just open it. It won't fit in the camera, but I'll just give you a peek. Okay. These are embroidered on a black machine, old machine. Because I went to a course to learn how to do this. 2 years I went. But this is very good quality. Oh, wow. And then what they did is, they did crochet on the edges. So this is actually this was a square tablecloth. And what they did is, they cut in the middle. Okay, this is the middle. They cut in the middle, and then they sewed these pieces. So what you do is you tie this to the rod of the curtain rod. So that's what I'm going to do. And you make a bow. Not good with bows, but I will make a bow. And then you hang this on your window. See? And then it gives you that nice look, feminine look. So that's what I like about it. So this was a tablecloth, and they cut it in the middle, and they, I believe they even I believe this was even on the tablecloth. So what they did is they cut it. I think so. That's what it looks like. But it was nicely secured and sewn. So I don't see any thread. As I bought from one of the seller, there was threads everywhere. Every time I opened the package, I was putting away thread. So it's nicely and clean. And it smells so good. So I don't know. I will go and check it once in a while, I guess. And I will ask the seller to ship it with regular post, not DHL related. I know it arrives in 3-4 business days, but the thing is, when it arrives, I have to pay custom fee, and I don't want to pay that. That's another money coming out of my pocket, even if it's $10, $20, $40. So I paid $42 for this. You know, $42, I could have bought something else, right? And we don't earn money easily. You know, I make my stuff by hand, and yeah, so I really like this. I'm really happy with my buy. And I don't know. I don't want to put her name out there because she's new. I was the first one who bought it. She shipped it first to Canada. And yeah, so I don't want you to, you know what I mean, right? Go through something bad. And I don't want to recommend at the moment, but we'll see in the future if I buy and if I get if I'm happy, and if she's more comfortable, then I will add her link where I bought it, and you guys can go and check out. But other than that, yeah, I'm not gonna share it at the moment. And it's very good quality. I really like. So these are all handmade, and I'm supporting. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed my unboxing. I know it's a small yarn and handmade unboxing, but I just wanted to share it with you before I open it and share it with my other, like opened it by myself. So I really like this crochet edge. What they did is they went back and forth to make the pyramid here, the rectangle, a triangle, as you can see. But it's really, really nice. Yeah. We'll take care, everybody. I'll just show it to you. Here's the side. Very nice. This is the back, actually. This is the front. And it's cotton. The fabric is in good quality cotton. Here's the other corner. If my memory card ends, if we get cut off, I'll see you on my next video. About 67 inches long, I believe, the length. Oh, it's still taping. Yeah, still taping. So it's about 67, I would say, 67 inches wide. I'm just trying to figure out how this part is done. Can you see? It's really neat. I really like it. Oh, wow.